Welcome students to my channel My Way Learning. Today we are going to learn about decimals. As you all are aware of fraction, now fractions having 10, 100, 1000 as their denominators are known as decimals. These numbers can be converted into decimals. Now let us see how. Let us look at the example 3/10. In decimal form, it can be written as 0.3. 5/100. Here we saw there are two zeros. So we put a decimal before the two places. But we have only 5. So we write down 0 in front of 5 and then put a point. So it will become 0.05. Same way, 7/1000. Here I have 3 zeros in the denominator, but in numerator I have only one number. So what I have to do, count from this place, I have to make it 3. So I put 2 zeros after decimal. So my number will become 0.007. Please remember, this zero is not the part of that zeros. Just give a look again. 3/10, only one place, so I put 0.3. Two zeros, 0.05. Three zeros, 0.007. These zeros have no value, but we write down just to not confuse the kids, so that they don't get confused or they forget to put the sign of decimal. Now let us understand decimal by using your number line. Here, this point is the center, which I represent by the decimal. This type of number line you are aware since childhood, ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000 and so on. Now the decimal is new to us. Let us see how to start with it. When we move from here to there, we jump 10 steps. But we speak it as 10th, then 100th, then 1000th, then 10,000th and so on. Just at 10th, th, th. At the end of the number, there is no one's place. It started with 10th, then 100th, then 1000th and so on. So basically, with each step, we multiply the number with 10. Just look in the above example. Here it is 10th, it is 100th. So what is the difference? 10 tens are 100, 100 tens are 1000. So the same thing I am explaining here. Then whenever you move forward, there is a difference of 10 steps. Same way in here, we jump 10 steps. 10 to 100, 10. 100 to 1000, again 10 steps. Now let us understand decimals more by using these figures. As I said, in decimals, they are fraction with having 10, 100 and 1000 as their denominator. So they always divide it into either 10 parts, either 100 parts or 1000 parts and so on. Here, I take a box which is divided into 10 equal parts and one of that is shaded. So what is its fraction? It is 1/10. Here in another box, that is a grid of 100 small boxes and 2 are shaded. So what is the fraction of it? It is 2/100. Which in further in the form of decimal can be written as 0.1. Now again using the rule, I have to count how many zeros? It is 1, 2. And what is the number in the numerator? It is only single digit number. but I have to put its 2 digit. So I put 0 in front of 2 and then decimal. So it will become 0.02. To make it more clear, I take the same example with different shading portion. Now they have 23 boxes which are shaded. So what is the fraction of it? It is 23/100. Count number of zeros. It is 2, 1, 2. So I have to put a decimal sign over there. Now it becomes 0.23 or 0.23. You can write it 0.23 or 0.23 itself. I think now this is clear to you. Let us understand more about decimals. Now let us understand how decimal can be written in their expanded form. Please mind, after using decimal, each digit can be named separately. Like this number can be read as 27.08. And if another number 3 is there, so I speak it like 27.083 and so on. Now let us understand or do its expanded form. Your number is 27. 20 plus 7. Now after decimal it is 0.08. This place is 10th place. So I write 0.0 plus, and this is your 100th place. So I need two places, 0.08. So this in its expanded form can be written like this by using decimal. If I have to use fraction form instead of decimal, I can write it like 20 plus 7. What is the value of that place? It is 0/10, and its place, that is 8/100. So it can also be write in this form. Now let us understand what are equivalent decimal. Someone told me 2.34 is equivalent to 2.340. And the other person say, how these two decimals are equivalent. Let us understand how they are equivalent. 2.34 in its fraction form can be written as 234/100, and 2.340 in its fraction form can be written as 2340/1000. Again, one can ask how they are equal. That number goes in up to 1000 place and this is only up to 100th place. Now let us check how they are equivalent. Now let us check, if I divide this number by 10 and this also by 10, what I get? It will become 234/100. Now what I notice, 2.34 is equivalent to 2.340. That is also equivalent to 2.34000, whatever the number of zeros you want, you can add at that place. Okay, but if I put 0 in that place, that are not equivalent. Let us take that example. Now let us check whether these two decimals are equivalent or not. One of my students say yes and another say no. So what is the correct answer? These two decimals are not equivalent. Let us check how. 2.04 in its fraction form can be written as 204/100, and 2.004 in its decimal form can be written as 2004/1000. Do they equal? No, not at all. In the previous example, I have 0 at that place, which we can use by dividing and cut them. But in this, the zeros are in the middle of two numbers, which cannot be divided by 10 simply. So these two fractions are not equivalent. So when we want to make some decimals to be equivalent, we add zeros at the back of the digit, at the last place, not in the middle. Like if you add zeros at that place, then they will not become equivalent. But if you add zeros at this place, then they become equivalent. So what are the equivalent decimals of this number? They are 2.04 is equivalent to 2.040 is equivalent to 2.0400 and so on. I hope now you are able to understand and to make decimal equivalent by adding zeros at this place, not at that place. In our today's section, we learn about decimals, which fraction will be converted into decimals, equivalent decimals, and which decimals are not equivalent, how to convert decimals into equivalent decimals, and their expanded form. I hope I make myself clear, and now you are aware from all of these topics. Don't forget to like, comment, and share my channel. For more updates, keep watching my channel, My Way Learning. Thank you.